Everyone thinks of changing the world, but no one thinks of changing himself. Leo Tolstoy. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic to parents and teachers, which is self-awareness. Usually during the interview, we ask candidates a very challenging question. What are your weaknesses? In most of the situations, nobody answers. Why? They do not know what their weaknesses are. We have a very important triangle, which is called strategic triangle. This triangle is needed for self-development. The three components of this triangle are self-awareness, willing, and motive. The obstacle usually is the self-awareness. So we are going to discuss the importance of self-awareness and what are the barriers that prevent all of us to know ourselves in the right way. And finally, we'll give you a lot of tips to help you as parents and teachers to deal with your children. There are three very hard things: steel, diamond, and self-awareness. We need to know the barriers that prevent us from knowing ourselves. We have a lot of subconscious mechanisms that prevent us from knowing ourselves. We are going to discuss each of them, but firstly, we have to know that each mechanism of them is unconscious. Unconscious means that it's inside myself, but I'm not aware with this mechanism. The first mechanism is rationalization. Rationalization means that your child is offering excuses for each mistake. The second mechanism is called denial. Denial, it means deny any mistake. For example, what smokers do is to deny the unhealthy effect of smoking in order to still smoke without any sense of guilt. The third mechanism is projection. Projection, it means I have a mistake or I have a weakness. I did not see this weakness in myself, while I see this weakness in others. This is called projection. The fourth mechanism is displacement. Displacement means finding a victim for your pent up. For example, you have punished your child. The child is going to move this punishment to his brother. Why? Because he is not able to confront himself with this mistake. Repression. Repression, it's unconscious forgetting. Moving a negative event from the conscious level into the unconscious level. What is the risk of this mechanism? The risk of this mechanism is developing inferiority complex or any type of complexes. Regression, it means withdrawal into the past. If you have a child of 15 years old and actually he has a new brother, a baby, the first one may start crying, suck his thumb. Why? Because this is called regression. It means going into a late phase. This is one of the defense mechanism of the psyche. Concerning the self-awareness, we have a very important model which is developed by two brothers, Joe and Harry. It's called Joe-Harry window. Joe-Harry window discusses the different components that each self has. We have four components: the open quadrant, the hidden quadrant, the blind quadrant, and the unknown quadrant. Open, it means known to me and known to others. Hidden, known to me and unknown to others. Blind, known to others and unknown to me. Unknown is unknown to me and unknown to others. The most risky quadrant of this model is the blind quadrant, which means a lot of mistakes known by others, but I'm not aware with them. So how to minimize this quadrant in order to know what are my weaknesses? This can be achieved through a lot of tips that will maximize the self-awareness and reduce the blind quadrant on the expense of the open quadrant. Now we are discussing the final part of this session, is the final tips to maximize the awareness of ourselves through our children. The first step, you have to evaluate yourself. We have to teach our children to have a session of 10 minutes at the end of each day to evaluate what happened during this day and have a two-way communication with themselves in order to know what were my mistakes and how to improve them. The second step is the feedback. Feedback means data about the past given during the present to affect the future. We have to teach our children to select someone to take and receive a feedback from him. The criteria are being honest, being expert, and being unbiased. Another tip for self-awareness is to teach our children how to know what motivates them. This is very important. Finally, we have to let our children to know what are the core values that they have. Core values do not mean integrity and honesty. Core values can be, for example, perfection, achievement, commitment. And finally, I need to close this session with a very nice quote. God support me to accept things I cannot change. Have the courage to change what can be changed. Thanks and see you soon.